Hey, what's up guys, welcome back. You're watching Full Take. Finally, Oneplus started to roll out their major update for Oneplus 12 and 13 series devices, which brought some of amazing features, including the new launcher with the iOS recents, for which all Oneplus users are waiting for. I'm using Oneplus 12R with OxygenOS 15 v701 EX01 update from last 1 month. As Oneplus just started to roll out this update globally and it will be available for all Indian users soon. So I didn't got its OTA in the stock OTA updater, but via OxygenOS updater I got 800 MB of v801 update. So I downloaded this update and started to flash it via local install. Today in this video, we are going to review all the new changes of this update along with the performance testing. So watch this video till the end because you will get the idea what new things Oneplus implemented in this update when you will get this update officially on your device. Now without further delay, let's get started. Our update installation is finished. It's recommended to optimize all your apps using Trinity Engine just after installation of update. OTA update section and version section is updated with the new OTA version OxygenOS 15 v801. This update comes with the same April SOTA version BRB1 EX01 v60p01. One thing I noticed here, in a kernel version, kernel is the same 5.15.149, similar like old build, but here it's showing Android version as Android 13 because it may be the old kernel from OxygenOS 13 version. We got the latest April 2025 security patches with this update, which is mentioned in the changelog also. Overall, this update is based on the new source code. Now let's check out the new features of this update. Oneplus added new partial screen recording feature, which can be considered as a new innovation of Oneplus. Google already introduced the partial screen recording in the Android 15, but it's recording the complete screen of application which you want to record. But Oneplus moved one step forward. In Oneplus partial screen recording, now we can record the specific part of the screen. We can set the screen recording size by dragging the partial screen recording window. Once your required area confirmed, tap OK icon. Now screen recording will be limited to the area which you have set it. And here you can check in the video recording, you can see the recorded video, which recorded the required part of the screen in the application which we have set it using the partial screen recording feature. Next big feature which is implemented by Oneplus in this update is a new iOS-like stacked recents task manager of Oneplus launcher. Oneplus system launcher is updated to the new version 15.4.14. If you go to the setting of this launcher, you will get this new stacked recent option in the manage option of the setting. We also get the small demo of this feature while accessing this setting first time in this update. We already created this video how you can enable this feature in an old build of OxygenOS launcher for all Oneplus devices which are running with the OxygenOS 15. You can check that video from the iCard video. But why this update? Now we got this feature officially. So if you are using Oneplus 12 and 13 series devices, you will get this nice iOS stacker recent, which looks cool. Oneplus maintained their rounded corner shape of clear all button in this launcher. Next, for multi-window apps can recognize the swipe up gesture, so you can easily close any multi-window application by swiping up smoothly without any delay. Next, Oneplus improved the shadow effect around the multi-window screens of the application. This is a subtle change, but you can notice the shadow effect of multi-window applications running over other applications. Next additional feature added in this update by Oneplus is Oneplus devices can now connect to the Apple's Mac devices and can transfer file between both of the devices by just using USB connect. So these are all the new changes of this update. As per every changelog, we gauge the system stability and the performance improvement in the changelog. So I did a small geekbench test for this update with and without performance mode, and here are the results. Without performance mode for single and multi-core, we got results of 901 and 3357. While with the performance mode, scores were highly improved and we got the score of 1846 and 4801. For OpenGL graphics API test, we got the score of 8591 and 8758 without and with performance mode enabled. While for the Vulkan graphics API, scores were 8743 and 9045 respectively. For GPU performance, there is a slight performance improvement was there after using high performance mode setting. Partial screen recording, iOS stack descents, Mac device interconnection, these are the major add-ons of this update. So you can consider this update is one of the major update after initial release of OxygenOS 15. This is all about for today guys. Hope you liked our work. Then please do like and share this video, subscribe to our channel, press the bell icon for notifications of our upcoming content related to OxygenOS, Oneplus and custom ROMs for Oneplus devices. Thanks for watching. See you next time. Take care. Bye bye.